All right, let's talk about everything going on right now. So regarding the Dow, okay, guys, let me, I know a lot of you guys think analytically too and so forth, but let me help you on something with that. Most of the information lately, not all of it, but most of the information that I've shared with you guys, God has actually pointed my eyes to that, and he put it on my heart to share it with you, okay? I'm not going to argue that information that God shows me, that I reveal to you, I'm not going to argue that information with you, because that was from God to me to you, okay? I'm not going to argue what he shows. But let me help you guys out. As you guys see, quite a few people, since I started bringing forth the prophetic, a lot of people said, you know, have argued that prophetic's inaccurate. Some have even said the Dow's not going to hit 20,000. As you guys see, everyone who's argued the prophetic, the Dow, they're all wrong. Guys, that's because if you know how to vet your prophecy, prophets who are accurate, their information's correct. And that's proven to be 100% factually true right before your eyes. I'm not bringing this up. And the reason why I started sharing Kim Clement's words with you right before the coronavirus went big and all that is because God put it on my heart to do so. Now look at the accuracy of it before your eyes. Not one of you can argue the accuracy of it. It's spot on at 100% accuracy, okay? Now, let me help you guys with the float. Yesterday I tried bringing, you know, the float, showing you that the Iraq dinar has a central, it's structured the exact same as the dollar. It floats now, okay? It has a back-end CBI market value of 1190, kind of like the US dollar has a treasury value of 100 cents, okay? But it has a market value, which changes. That's a float. Okay. Now see, here's one of our followers that told me I was incorrect, that it doesn't currently float because they're saying it, why would it not be at $3.20 now if it floated? Guys, it's a controlled managed float. The US dollar is under controlled managed float. All of the US financial markets are controlled and managed. That's what, see, remember I told you guys, all the markets, this whole deal about the coronavirus collapsing our financial markets, guys, it's just a game. Because remember I told you, they had to bring our inflation, if you guys don't study the US economics, our inflation was very high. They had to bring down our markets because of how high the inflation was. Our inflation was getting too high at the beginning of the year. They had to bring the markets down to control and reduce inflation, okay? These financial markets are no different. They're controlled and managed. They can only operate within a small, narrow window. And that's why the Iraq dinar stays within a small window, but it currently floats. It shifts, it changes. That's what a float is. A float means it has a window. It's got a low point and a high point, and it can just cycle inside and shift and change inside that window between the high and low points. Okay, that's why it doesn't go up to 320, Mr. Mark Rogers, okay? Guys, this, you know, I try to bring forth the information, I try to share with you and show you what God puts on my heart. I even use a lot of factual data, and then people just try to come out and argue, and it just makes it challenging to share information, you know, when information that you put facts behind to show you gets argued. So anyway, all right, let me show you this. All right, so I took a screenshot from XE.com. Now, notice how it says the value of the dinar is 0.9545. That doesn't say 1190. It says 0.9545, okay? Because it has the market value is separate than the CBI's value. Just like the US dollar, they're structured the exact same. It has a central bank value, and then it has a market-driven value that shifts and changes based on supply and demand. But again, it can only shift and change within a narrow window because it's a controlled managed float. Now, let me show you it shifts and changes just like the dollar. Now, right here in this first screenshot, look at the bottom value. It says that one US dollar equals 1,194.5564 IQD. See after the decimal, the 5564? Let's go to the other screenshot on this one. It doesn't say 5564 after the decimal. It says 4283, guys. That's because both the dollar and the dinar are structured the exact same. structured the same. They both change and shift based on market demand. Guys, they're just putting misleading information in the news. I've tried telling you just in the last few videos that all of the news coming out is smoke, mirrors, and BS. Be careful what you believe. It's already floating. What they basically told you in the float article is it's going to stay structured exactly how it is, okay? That, you know, it's deceived. They're trying to mislead you, and that's all this is. But again, see right here, this one, this value of $1 per dinar, okay, after it's 1198.4283, and the previous one ends in 5564, okay? That's because they're structured the same. That's what I tried to tell you in a video last night, but then there's the few that like to argue. So anyway, and when I try to show you facts and prove it, and I already proved to you last night factually that the dollar does float. The dollar's not a fixed rate. It floats. Well, guys, so does the erect dinar. So anyway, guys, be very careful what information you choose to believe, because like 98% of what's come, the only accurate information that's been coming out lately, guys, is just banking news. All this rest of it has just been lies and BS to mislead and confuse you. God bless you guys. Have a great day.